look to you. Searching for that open door. And every road that I've taken led to my regret. And I don't know if I'm gonna make it. Nothing to do but lift my head. I look to you. I look to you. Thank you.
Even from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. For a thousand years in sight, above yesterday when it passed. And as watching the night, they are as sleep. In the morning they are grass which groweth up. And in the evening it is cut down and it withereth. So teach us, Lord, to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. The Lord is my shepherd. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leadeth me beside the still waters. My soul, for he leadeth me of righteousness. For his name's sake, yea, though through the valley of the shadow, I will fear no evil. Thou art thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil and runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy thou follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Let not your hearts be troubled, for ye believe in God. Believe also in me, for in my Father's house are many mansions, and if it were not so, I would have told you. For I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive where I am. You may be also, and whither I go, and away. Thomas said unto him, Lord, not whither thou goest, and how we know the way. Jesus said unto him, for I am the truth and the life. No man cometh to the Father but by me. Christ risen from the dead and became the fruits of them that sinned. For by man came death, by man also came the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ all be made alive. You may be seated. At this time, I'm going to continue with what the family has laid out. Now we're going to have a selection. The Word of Life praise team.
You are my strength, strength like no other, strength like no other, reaches to me, say you are my strength,
you are my strength,
strength like no other,
strength like no
strength like no other,
like no other,
reaches
to me.
Say you are my strength,
you are my strength,
stream like no other.
Stream like no other.
Reaches
to me.
In the fullness, say, in the fullness of
your,
come on, Jessica,
and the power of
you lift
me up.
Oh, you lift me up. Lift me up in the fullness of your grace.
In the fullness of your
grace. In the power of your name.
Your name.
You lift me up. Oh, you lift me up, Lord.
Lift me up.
I like this in his face. Unfailing love, yeah, is stronger than mountains. It's deeper than oceans. It reaches to me. Say, unfailing love.
Unfailing love.
Stronger than mountains.
Stronger than mountains.
Deeper than ocean.
Deeper than ocean.
And it reaches
to me.
Unfailing love.
Unfailing love.
Stronger than mountains.
Stronger than mountains.
Deeper than oceans.
Deeper than oceans.
And it reaches.
Reaches to me.
In the fullness of your grace.
In the fullness of your grace.
In the power of your name,
the
name that's above every name,
you lift me up.
Oh, you lift me up, Lord.
Lift me up
in the fullness of your grace.
In the fullness of your grace.
In the power of your name.
In the power of
your name is a strong tower.
You lift me up.
Oh, you lift me up, Lord.
Lift me up.
You are my strength, say.
You are my strength.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
Strength like no other.
And it reaches.
Reaches to me.
Say it one more time. You are my strength.
My strength,
the everlasting strength like no other. Strength like no other.
Reaches
to me. Hallelujah.
Father, we thank you for another day. We thank you for another opportunity, God. God, as we come to celebrate one who lived his life, God, we thank you for connections. Thank you for allowing us the opportunity to be connected to our uncle, our father, our brother, our cousin, and our friend. God, I ask for strength right now. Strength in the middle of a season of confusion. I ask for strength in the middle of a season of uncertainty. I ask for strength in the middle of chaos. God, I ask that you just touch right now. Touch whatever the need may be. Touch whatever the circumstance may be. God, give the family strength to understand. God, I ask right now that if anyone is disconnected, I pray that you connect them right now. I pray that you connect and tie up any loose ends. God, I thank you for being God all by yourself. God, I ask right now that you strengthen the family, all that are connected. And God, I pray that his soul rests with you. God, I pray that he continues to speak the word, but speak it from on high. God, I pray that you allow his memories to live on and to share through our day-to-day lives, through the conversations, through the acts that he did, through the word that he taught, through the Sunday school lesson that he taught. God, we know our uncle, our brother, our cousin, our friend, our grandfather, our father knew the word of God. God, we thank you for him knowing the importance of the word of God and sharing that word with his family. God, we ask right now that you just allow us to continue to do what we've been taught to do. Continue to allow that light to shine so that somebody down in the valley will find their way home. In the name of Jesus, we ask it all. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we'll have a scripture reading, both Old Testament and New Testament, from Reverend Anthony Sims. And we're going to ask that Brother Herbert Suber and Deacon Marcellus Davis come with remarks in that order. Amen? Amen.
Notice our Old Testament is Job 14 chapter. This is the NIV version. Man born of a woman are a few days and full of trouble. They spring up like flowers and wither away. Like fleeting shadows, they do not endure. Down to verse 13. If only you would hide me in the grave and conceal me until your anger has passed. If only you would set me a time and then remember me. If someone dies, will they live again? All the days of my life, I will wait for my change to come. A New Testament is found in 2 Corinthians, the 5th chapter, beginning with verse number 1. For we know that if this earthly tent were dissolved, we have a building from God, an eternal house in heaven, not built by human hands. Meanwhile, we groan, longing to be clothed instead with our heavenly dwelling, because when we are clothed, we will not be found naked. For while we are in this body, we groan and are burdened, because we do not know, or do not wish to be unclothed, but to be clothed upon with our heavenly dwelling, so that it is mortal may be swallowed up by life. Now he that has brought us for the same thing is God. Therefore we are always confident and know that while we are at home in this body, we are absent from the Lord. For we walk by faith, not by sight. We are confident, I say, and willing to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. May God's word be a seed of hope for your hearts.
Thank you.
long have I got to talk about William? I've known William all my life. He knew me all my life. He was like a big brother to my family. He always visited my mom. I don't know if they had ways of life or what. He just always visited my mom, and he always looked out for others. I always got to sit in a little bit of trouble too. He was always, and every time you saw him, he had that big smile. You know, when I first come to know William, he was cutting forward. He was a mighty man. He grew up doing hard work just like I did. I never cut no forward with him, but everything else hard I have done. But William, I can recall when I was a child, he would come off. They was cutting forward behind where we lived at. We had to walk about a mile and a half to get water to drink. So we had an old wagon with iron wheels on it. So we'd pull the wagon up to the store, and they was hauling pulpwood. With pulpwood, when you had, they didn't have nothing to load on the truck. You did it by manpower. His dad and family was doing it then. And he would we would pull the wagon up to the old general store. The weather opened, but we pulled the wagon up, and there was a well there, and we get all the drinking water from there. And he'd pull it back to one, he didn't kill us. But he'd tie a rope to the old pulpwood truck and pull it back down the road about a mile and a half to the house with a big metal chun on the back of the wagon. And then when I grew up, became a teenager, he was working at Target. Well, I knew him in the church, though. He was at the church. We all grew up in the church together. But as a teenager, he was working third shift at Target. And I was in high school. I was working third shift at Lydia Mills. And I had Bone Mill because we met a nice car. He named me Fred Flintstone. So he called me Fred Flintstone. He come and pick my brother up. He come and pick my brother up, and they would ride to Charleston to get him. And I make sure I pass him every night, because he always talked about my old raggedy car. But every night, my brother said, when you see the lights come up the hill, I'll be gaining on him. He said, here come old Fred Flintstone. Then later on, I left town. And I come back to town and started back to church. He was in the church, and you know, it just amazed me. You know, he would do Sunday school when I became a teacher. He gave me books and stuff to read. He lectured me on things that I needed to know. I mean, it was just amazing. We started calling him at the church the historian, because he knew things about the Bible that, you know, that what you could listen to the preacher preaching, but he could tell you some things about that. What he was preaching about, the prophet that he was preaching about, and even the pastor started calling him the historian. And one day he was going to Sunday school, and he could tell you a lot of times when people, maybe two people there or three people there, but I was always interested in what he had to say about what was said in the Bible, and I was wondering where did he get his information from. So I read the Sunday school lesson and then get it, and he started telling me things, and I just grew. I thank God for our past promises, because I grew in my relationship with God through William Pride. And now I do the Sunday school. I don't know if God was telling him that this man gonna have to take over the job or what. But he taught me some things that I really need to know. And neither one of them I could say, he could say either. But he would sing a song and do a prayer before the Sunday school. And I do the same thing. We laugh about it. He tells me, Bible said, make a joyful noise. That's what we do. And we grew on that. And I say this, William was a cousin to me, he was a big brother to me, he was a friend to me, he was a mentor to me, and I never saw him when he didn't have
when he didn't have a big smile on his face. And always had something to tell you to make you laugh. And when he didn't have something to tell you to laugh, I knew he was fading away. And I thank God for our past promises. You know, God chooses who family to be in. And he put him in the family for a reason. And everything that I learned from him, I take it to heart and I thank God for it. I say this to the family, because I'm the family too. The tears that I shed for him will be tears of joy and tears of relief. Not tears of grief. Because, hey, I thank the good mama, the big smile that he had. So I say to the family, when you start thinking about that big smile and the things that he always said. Now, one saying he always said, "Now, son, you know." when he told you that, he figured you already know better. he always told me about the Sunday school lesson. Study to show yourself approved. So when the preacher could be preaching and hey, you can't say nothing, but Sunday school that was he said, and another saying that we had, forsake not the assembly of the saints. And he was always, until he started to fade away, he was always there for Sunday school, and he was always there for Bible study. So I say to the family, hey, I know we're going to miss him, but hey, it's been a pleasure knowing him, and I thank God for it.
Amen.
Davis, I'm going to ask at this time that the mortuary staff come and do the please.
Together again, a reunion occurred in heaven this week of the sweetest and most joyful kind. As William's spirit moved beyond this earth, released from his mortal life. And what a reunion it must have been, a joy beyond our conceiving, when a husband met his wife in heaven again, ending years of dignified grieving. Although we will miss them terribly, and we'll long for them with deepest grief, we are reminded that love is more powerful than death, and this knowledge gives us comfort and peace. We can still feel their love surround us, giving us a desire to continue on, to try our best to live our lives well in the ways they would have done. For we know this isn't the only reunion. Someday we'll be called back to be with them. For life can lead us to greater happiness with the Lord and our loved ones in heaven. Acknowledgement. The family wishes to acknowledge with deep appreciation the many expressions of love, concern, and kindness shown to them during their hour of bereavement. May God bless and keep you all, the family. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. I'm going to take a brief moment and just say thank you to Lynn San for this opportunity. Y'all and Q1 continue to keep you all in our hearts and prayers. I think it's safe to say, instead of saying the family, our family. Because as I look around, more of us are connected than not connected. So we all family. Thank you all for the opportunity. We'll continue to keep you in prayer. At this time, we're going to ask that the Word of Life praise team come around for another selection. Following that selection, we'll have words of comfort from Pastor Ronnie Mims. Amen.
The Lord is my shepherd.
Lord is my shepherd.
He goes before me.
He goes before me.
A defender behind me.
Defender behind me.
I won't fear.
I won't fear.
I'm filled with anointing.
I'm filled with anointing.
My cup's overflowing.
My cup's overflowing.
No weapon can harm me.
No weapon can harm me.
I won't fear.
I won't fear.
Sing hallelujah. Hallelujah. I am not alone. Yeah. He's my comfort.
He's my comfort.
And he always,
always,
he always holds me close. He always guides me.
He always guides me.
Through mountains and valleys.
Through mountains and valleys.
His joy is refreshing.
His joy is refreshing.
It restores my soul.
Restores my soul.
Mercy and goodness.
Mercy, mercy and goodness.
It gives me assurance,
gives me assurance
that I will see,
I'll see his glory
face to face,
face to face.
Hallelujah. Comfort.
He's my God.
And he always,
always holds me close.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I am not alone.
He's my comfort.
He's my comfort,
and he always,
always holds me close.
He always guides me.
He always guides me
through mountains and valleys.
Through mountains and valleys.
His joy is refreshing.
His joy is refreshing.
It restores my soul.
Restores my soul.
Mercy and goodness.
Mercy and goodness.
It gives me assurance.
Gives me assurance.
That I will see.
I'll see his glory.
Face to hallelujah.
Hallelujah. I am not alone.
He's my comfort.
He's my comfort. Always holds me close.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah, I am not alone.
Amen, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah to the Lamb of God, amen. You know, in times like this, we have to go back to what we know. And what we know is, Reverend Sims was reading the scripture from 2 Corinthians 5 and 8, to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. Amen. And it's what you know that gets you through the time of crisis that you face. And just like the song, we are never alone. He will never leave us, and he will not forsake us. Hallelujah. So I can praise him right in the midst of the storm. Hallelujah. And when I praise him, his presence begin to show up on the scene. Answers begin to be released. You see, the Apostle Paul said it like this. He said, the Lord Jesus Christ's grace. He said, in my weakness, when I run out of strength, when I run out of myself, that's when his strength is made perfect. That's when his strength takes over. And that's what I want us to draw in this service today. I want us to draw off his strength. Amen. Hallelujah. Just by you being here today, tell us how Deacon William Price have impacted your life. Whether family or visitors, that let me know. And I like, as one of the remarks was saying, he taught Sunday school. He was there at Bible study. So that let you know he had a commitment to the Word of God. But I had the opportunity, he came at, when his wife came to the church, and he started coming with her. And when she went on to be with the Lord, he wasn't the same. He missed his wife so much. And even in service, I would hear him sometimes talking to his wife. Well, the Bible tells us clearly to be absent from the body is to be present with the Lord. And that means he's with his wife again, praise God. And I believe as we talk about a celebration of life, it's a homegoing service. Because we know Deacon William Price made Jesus Christ Lord of his life. And because of that, praise God, I know the family, I know y'all going to miss him. But my God, he's walking streets of gold right now. And he's with the Lord Jesus Christ. And much as he loved you guys, when you get a glimpse over to the other side, when you actually step out of your body and step into his presence, nothing else compares. Amen. Amen. What Deacon Price did, all of us going to have to do one day unless the rapture happened first. Amen. 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 So I believe on my own assignment, and I was praying and asking the Lord, what is it you want me to share with your people today? You know, to be honest, I was up to 2 or 3 o'clock because wasn't nothing coming together. And then around about 3 o'clock, the Lord said, I want you to tell them about the Father's plan. I want to talk to you about the Father's plan. Well. And our scripture going to be coming and from Jeremiah 29 and 11. And it says, I know the thoughts that I think towards you, says the Lord. And it starts of peace and not evil to give us an expected end, a final outcome. Well, let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we draw on you right now. Lord, as we stand in your presence, we choose to rejoice because we had Deacon William Price around all these years. All these years, Lord, being faithful to the church that he went to. Teaching Sunday school, mentoring others. Now, Lord, what he did helped us to pass down what he did to be faithful. Oh, I thank you. And right now, Lord, I pray that every eye is anointed to see, every ear is anointed to hear, every heart is anointed to receive what the Spirit of the Lord is saying and doing. And Father, everything you do, oh my God, we're going to be careful to give you the praise. We're going to be careful to give you the glory. We're going to be careful to give you the honor. Because it's in the matchless, majestic name of our Lord Jesus Christ that we bless you in this place right now. Amen and amen. So God came up with a plan, praise God. Because he knew times like this was going to be coming.